Well, everybody, it's so great to have you back down off the mountain. Unfortunately, Lloyd and I couldn't be there this year, but we know what you've been through because we've been there. And we know the privilege that God has placed upon each and every one of you. Every time you touch that mountain up in the lake, something happens, something special takes place. We already heard the good stories. We heard the good news of people being healed, of people receiving power of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus, our prayer to answer.
Amen.
Know that we were praying for you the whole time as I was being splished and splashed and hit with stuff from our little nephew's birthday party. They had little guns shooting water all over you, so we were soaking in wet. But we still prayed and thought about the pool up in Loon Lake and thought about the canoeing, and then we heard about the message that Jim gave. Thank you, Jesus, for what you do in the lives of each and every one of us. So here we are.
Yes.
Here we are. And it's Sunday, it's Father's Day.
Yes.
Father's Day. And to all the fathers here, including Lloyd and myself, we're both fathers, we have grandchildren. And we're so grateful to God for what he's done in our lives. And here we are in different circumstances, but still dads to our children. And we're so grateful for that. But you know, today is Father's Day, and we get to praise and worship and give glory to the greatest father ever.
Yeah.
We get to give glory to Papa.
Yes.
To our Heavenly Father, to say thank you, Father, for what you've done for us. How you sacrificed your own son so that we could be here. And for everything that we've gone through, that you put your son through that. What greater love could any father give? And I know here on earth, there are many fathers who would do the same thing for their sons and daughters. They would take debt over anything. And we watched The Shack last night, oh my glory. The first time I saw the movie, I tell you I never want to see it again because I hardly saw it. I bawled so much and I was in tears. But the message is so poignant. The message is so poignant. So now I want to read the book again. So here we are, and I'm grateful and thankful to God for being there. Each and every step of my life, even when I didn't even know it. I hadn't have a clue, but he stood by my side. He picked me up when I was down. He dragged me around when I didn't want to go and pulled me in by his side and said, I need you to stay, but you know if you're not going to, it's your will. But please stay by me. And thank God I made that decision many years ago. Lloyd and I in a little church in Casa de Cristo in Phoenix, Arizona. Unbeknownst to each of us, a song was playing. We were standing on holy ground, and I really believe that this is holy ground that we stand on. Every time I come here Sunday night, and Lighthouse of Hope Christian Fellowship is seated, this is holy ground. Holy Spirit precedes us. And we accepted the Lord at the same time, unbeknownst to each of us. I didn't know Lloyd was accepting Christ, and he didn't know I was. But you know, we had a mother, or Lloyd has a mother, she was my mother-in-law, who always believed that one day, she prayed, and when we were talking about prayer, prayed and prayed and prayed daily, that Lloyd and I would see the light, and that we would accept Jesus Christ as our personal saviors. And in that little church in Phoenix, Arizona, we did that. And when Lloyd called his mother, because he was so excited to tell her the news, she said, I know. Very anticlimactic, I know. So we knew God had been talking to her beforehand, so she accepted the news. So here we are, and I just want to thank God for this song, to Dallas Home for writing these beautiful words and allowing it to be an impact in my heart, and hopefully it will be on yours. Stretch it, talk. Okay. What can I say? A person who writes these beautiful songs, Dallas Home, he's written so many glorious, wonderful Christian songs. And keep him in your prayers because his wife, Linda, has just found out she has cancer. You know, there's that disease again that we all have to fight against and keep praying. Lord, take that awful disease away from each and every person that has it or may contact it. Please take it away. Keep stretching. Okay.
Okay.
in your presence, lifting holy hands to you. Here we are, praising Jesus for the things He's brought us through. I don't have the words to tell you how I just don't know what I can say. I'm not worthy to be your holy day. Yet you tell me you love me just the same.
Here we are, in your presence.